it's very hard to introduce this book. I mean, to summarize this book. In a way, this book refuses to be summarized because there are so many optional plots. I'll do my best. It's the main protagonist is Esther. She's 16-year-old, rebellious young girl who is sent by her family to Africa, to Cameroon, to her uncle, Monsieur Sicurel, who is a big merchant there. And the family, the conspiracy of the family is to settle her down, to marry her with her cousin, who is, a failure. And this is, you know, the basic plot of Esther coming to Douala in Africa, her encounter with the French, Belgian, European, very small and narrow-minded society there. And through this story, there is, of course, the story of a Jewish Egyptian family that it is spread all over the world, America, Australia, France, Africa, including Israel. So there are many plots are hidden inside in this, let's say, 19th century plot about the young girl who is sent by her family. You can call it family heritage, but this family heritage is very suspicious because people have many stories and contradictory stories about this family heritage. So there isn't one story about the family heritage, you see? It's, versions of the history heritage. And I have to tell that in most cases, if you dig, it's like that. It's like that. The non-realistic novel is the realistic novel in the sense that, you know, this novel about the family with the family heritage, the linear novel, very realistic one. In many senses, it's not realistic because most families are not so, you know, are not like this. Writing also, well, all the time, most of the time, has to do a lot with digging. I mean, not to accept the surface. If you accept the surface of reality of things, I suppose that you don't feel a need to write, okay? If you take the things as they are. So I suppose that writing is always, almost always, digging in something, scratching something. It's true. I haven't used photos like this, exactly like this, because I don't like to repeat myself. So I wouldn't do it again like this. But it's true, on the other hand, that photography and photos has a very, meaningful place in my writing because I'm very much influenced by photography. But it has many performances in my writing, the photography. Not like in this book. This book, in this sense, is very unique, the usage of photos and photography. I took it to the extreme. I have to emphasize that I wrote this book on the 90s, don't forget this. This book was written on 92, something like that. Well, I love Roland Barthes, but especially his book Pensées sur la photographie. And before writing this book, this novel, I think his book was an inspiration for me. In many ways, it was an inspiration. I really was influenced by this book. It really accompanied me during writing because his perspective on photography. I think that Roland Barthes' view that a photograph is an evidence and at the same time it's a fiction. his perspective that photograph is an evidence to reality and it's a fiction of reality. And this understanding gave me a lot. It's brilliant, really, and it's true. Because every time we are looking at a photograph, we are not only remember ourselves, but we invent ourselves.